Hey guys, I've been experimenting with ChatGPT over the past few weeks, and in this video I will demonstrate how you can utilize ChatGPT and Python to automate Excel and make your life easier.
Specifically, I will go over some practical Excel automation ideas. For all examples in this video, I have also created a tutorial in the past, so we will be also comparing some of the solutions from ChatGPT to the ones I came up with. Okay, so let's start with the first example. I have a bunch of Excel files in my input folder, and I want to replace all instances of small business with small market and mid-market with mid-size market in all worksheets of the files. So here's what I asked ChatGPT to do. Using Python, iterate through all Excel files in the input directory and replace instances of small business with small market and mid-market with mid-size market in each sheet of each file. Save the modified workbook in the output folder, create it if it doesn't exist. To my surprise, ChatGPT was able to write the entire script for me and even included comments explaining each step. I then copied and pasted the code into an empty Python file and ran it. Now, if we look in the output folder, we can see our modified spreadsheet. Let me open one up to show you the changes. As you can see, small business has been replaced with small market and mid-market with mid-size market in all worksheets. This is already pretty impressive, and I like that ChatGPT included the comments to explain the code in more detail. In the past, I created a solution to this problem using a dictionary for the replacement pairs in case I wanted to add more values. Nevertheless, the output is the same and ChatGPT accomplished my task. However, in the next example, I ran into some issues. I wanted ChatGPT to write a script to save each worksheet in this spreadsheet as a new workbook with only the values, and the workbook should have the same name as the sheet while maintaining the same worksheet format. The new workbooks should be placed in a folder called Output. If that folder doesn't exist, it should be created. So I asked ChatGPT for a solution, and it gave me a script including the description. As before, I took the code, pasted it into my text editor and executed it. The code ran without any errors, and also in my folder, I now have my output directory with the different Excel files. Yet when I checked the result, I noticed that the provided script didn't keep the original format, it just copied the values. While it was a good start, it wasn't perfect. However, one of the great things about ChatGPT is that you can ask follow-up questions. So I asked how I could prevent the formatting from being lost in the new workbook. ChatGPT modified then the code and added a couple of lines to copy the formatting. I ran the code again, yet I got the following error message. I then asked ChatGPT to fix this error, and it provided me with a modified version of the code, but also that version didn't work, so it was leading to nowhere. As I said, also for this use case, I have created a dedicated video on my channel. In that video, I used the Python package Excelwings to keep the formatting because I knew it would be tough to do with OpenPyXL. So if you already know which package you want to use, you can tell ChatGPT to do so. This is what I did in the next example. In this Excel workbook, I have two worksheets. The data worksheet contains financial information for different countries. The task I gave to ChatGPT is as follows. Using Python and Pandas, filter the financial data XLSX workbook for the year 2021 by the unique values in column B, so country. Load only the data sheet and extract the financial data from column A to P for each unique country value. Create a new Excel file for each country containing only the financial data for that country in 2021. Save each Excel file in the attachments folder and name each file after the corresponding country. If the attachments folder doesn't exist, create it before saving the files. As you can see, this time I specified that ChatGPT should use pandas in its code generation. The result was a pandas solution with some helpful explanations at the end. Just like before, I copied the code into my text editor and ran it. And just like that, we have the new workbooks in our attachments folder. Let me open up the Canada file to ensure everything is working as expected. If I apply a filter to the workbook, we can see that it only contains the data for Canada in 2021. So when you know which Python packages you want to use, make sure that you specify those in your prompts. Another useful feature of ChatGPT is its ability to not only generate new code, but also improve existing code. As an example, let's consider taking the same spreadsheet and saving each worksheet as a separate workbook. To do this, I created a solution using Excel rings. Also, for this task, you can find a video on my channel. I will go ahead and run the code to test it out. After it's done, we will have a new output folder with two workbooks. The data spreadsheet will now only contain the data worksheet. So far, so good. I then asked ChatGPT to look at my Python code and add some comments to it. The result was code with comments explaining what each line does. It might be a bit overkill to have a comment for every single line, but I could have also asked ChatGPT to only include comments for the most important parts. Another awesome thing is that you can keep talking to it as you go. So while you are writing documentation or checking out some new code online, you can ask ChatGPT to clarify what certain code does, which will help you understand what's going on. I also asked ChatGPT to convert my code into a function, and it was able to do so, complete with type hints and a doc string with explanations of the arguments. As before, I ran this code and it worked perfectly. All of these capabilities are really impressive. And of course, ChatGPT isn't just limited to automating Excel tasks. Essentially, you can use it to try and automate any tedious office task you might have. In my final example, I asked ChatGPT to create a Python script that generates a PowerPoint presentation with 3 slides. The first slide should have the title Introduction and include 3 bullet points on the left and an image of a dog on the right obtained from an API. The second slide should have the title Methods and include 3 bullet points on the left and an image of a dog on the right. The third slide should have the title Results and also include 3 bullet points on the left and an image of a dog on the right. ChatGPT should use functions and best practices to make the code Pythonic and reusable. The PowerPoint should be saved with the name My Awesome PPT. In response to this prompt, I received the following code. We can see that there are different functions for creating the presentation. As before, ChatGPT provided a summary of what the code does and mentioned that a specific Python library is required to use the code. All I had to do was copy and paste the code, which I did. After running this code, Python created the following PowerPoint presentation. While the presentation isn't exactly visually appealing, and the layout is different from what I had in mind, the bullet point should have been on the left and the image on the right, it is still a solid starting point. So, what is my conclusion? If you have office tasks you want to automate, ChatGPT is definitely worth a try. However, the most difficult part for me was writing a concise and clear prompt that accurately conveyed what I wanted to do, especially for more complex tasks. It's a good idea to break these tasks into smaller subtasks and ask ChatGPT to automate them separately before piecing them together. Additionally, it's important to keep in mind that the code provided by ChatGPT may not always work as expected, so you may need to troubleshoot and make adjustments as necessary. Despite these considerations, I think that ChatGPT is a powerful tool that can help you to make your office life easier. I would highly recommend giving it a try. Also, let me know your opinion about ChatGPT in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video!